Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about how I got started with coding. Okay, so today I'm coming to you from the town of Newbury, which is in North Berkshire. And I want to answer a question that came in the other day from Daniel Villanueva, who says, can you make a video on how did you start coding? This is a good one, Daniel. And when it comes to being a software developer, in a lot of ways, I still feel like a fraud because when I was growing up, I never intended to get into software development at all. Now, I've told this story before, so I don't want to go too much into it, but I didn't start doing any code until I was 25 years old. So my career progression was I was in high school, and then I went into the Army. I was 4 years in the Army. Then I went to university, and I studied history. So I was certified to teach history in the state of Missouri before leaving the U.S. and coming over here. And when I came over here, I didn't have any job prospects at all. It was very, very difficult, and for the first few months, I worked in a factory, and I was just packing yogurt into boxes. That was my job, 8 hours a day. And then the other part of the day, which when I was awake, was doing CVs and sending CVs off. And I applied for everything, regardless of whether or not I was qualified for it. And eventually I got a job as a trainee software developer. And I told them right out, I didn't lie on my CV or anything. I said, I don't have any experience as a programmer, but I'm very willing to learn. And somehow, and I still think it may have been a clerical error, they hired me. And I can remember starting that job because I did have a little bit of programming experience before that. In the 80s, we had a VIC 20 and I wrote a program that was like line 10, print, hello world, line 20, go to 10. And it would just repeat the same thing over and over again. If you've done any programming on a Commodore VIC 20, that's pretty much all you could do on it. So I had that little bit of experience, so I started a job. I spent every single waking hour, it seems like, trying to learn how to do that. I was trying to play catch up. I was trying to make myself useful by learning Excel and Access and doing this kind of stuff. But at the same time, trying to learn Visual Basic, trying to learn web development, trying to learn all these other different things. And for a while, I remember thinking that this was too hard for me. See, one of the benefits I had where somebody who's coming in and you just want to get started, one of the benefits I had that those people wouldn't have is that I had a reason to learn it. I had to learn it. Like if I didn't learn it, I would have lost my job. If I didn't keep at the books, I would end up losing that opportunity that I had. So that kept me going, even when there's a voice in the back of my head saying, this is too hard for you, right? So sometimes you just need that little bit of extra push. But I want to, having gone through all that, having been a software developer for over 20 years and doing pretty well financially when I was a contractor and doing pretty well on my own in terms of software development, I would like to say this to anybody out there who's getting started. It's not as hard as you think, right? If you look at something like machine learning or you look at some really complex algorithms and complex coding, that's not where you start. You start with the easy stuff. You start with drag and drop forms on a controls on a form, you write the back end for that, you go bit by bit, you write really bad code to get started, it's going to happen. You can write bad code and you're going to get better as you go. Some people stop growing as they code and other people, they're just constantly improving themselves as they go. But it can be very intimidating to get started, Daniel. I mean, it could, like, as I know because I went through it. And there's still aspects of programming where I start learning it and it's that voice in the back of your head. It's not that you can't learn it. You could if you applied yourself. It's a little voice in the back of your head saying, actually, Eric, you're not smart enough for this. And that happened in the beginning days of programming, but I just kept at it. And eventually, it was funny how some things were just so nebulous to me, so nebulous to my understanding. And then one day, they just clicked like that, right? And this is the way with machine learning right now. Like I keep reading these books on machine learning and all the different aspects of that. And sometimes it just seems like, dude, this is too hard. I am not smart enough to learn this. But I know it's that voice in the back of my head that stops me. So anyway, I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. For those of you guys who are thinking about getting into programming and haven't started yet, put in the comments that, and for those of you guys who are software developers and you think it, and you found, and when you got started, did you have those voices in the back of your head? Because I sure did. Anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again next time. Wait. Okay, I always forget this part. Now, if you made it all the way to the end of the video, please go ahead and click the like button. And if you are new to this channel, please go ahead and subscribe. We're constantly talking about app development and software development on this channel, and it would be fantastic if you joined the discussion. Anyway, I'll talk to you guys again next time.